The Parthenon Marbles are a set of marble sculptures created by the Greek sculptor Phidias and his assistants sometime between 447 and 432 BC, and they're at the center of a nearly 200-year dispute between Greece and the United Kingdom. So what's it all about? Well, essentially, the Parthenon Marbles currently reside in the British Museum in London, and the Greeks would like them back. What this really comes down to, though, is how we define ownership, or as Barbara Krueger puts it, who owns what? As with anything, it's partly a question of context. To really understand what's happening here, we need first to look at the building itself. The Parthenon is a massive Doric temple dedicated to Athena, the Greek goddess of wisdom, and was designed to symbolize strength, power, intelligence, and harmony. It was built at the center of the famous Athenian Acropolis and is done entirely in marble quarried from nearby Mount Pentelicus, and as a testament to Greek identity, it has no equal. Like many ancient Greek temples, it tells a story, that of Greek heroism. Inscribed along the metopes, we see battles depicting Greek civilization and ethos triumphing over a barbaric other, figured here in the form of centaurs, Amazons, giants, or Trojans. In other words, they're deeply, intimately about what it means to be Greek. So how did the fragments of this sculpture get to the UK? At the turn of the 19th century, Thomas Bruce, the 7th Earl of Elgin, served as ambassador to the Ottoman Empire. At this time, the Turks had occupied Greece, and the Parthenon was in a bit of a state. Over the years, it had been converted into a church, a mosque, and an ammunition depot. It had sustained extensive structural damage and had been picked apart by looters. When Lord Elgin arrived in Athens, he recognized the profound artistic and cultural significance of the building and hired artists and sculptors to make sketches and casts, intending to bring these back to Britain. Later, he felt compelled to remove pieces of the Parthenon as well, bit by bit, to bring them back, too. In the end, he removed about 50% of the marbles. Motivation is always a tricky thing to talk about, and Lord Elgin's case is no exception. There are a few possibilities. He may have been motivated by a sincere desire to foster greater cultural enlightenment and understanding. There's also an argument to be made for preservation. According to author William Hamilton, Elgin wanted to rescue from oblivion with the most accurate detail whatever specimens of architecture and sculpture in Greece had still escaped the ravages of time and the barbarism of the conquerors. Or it could be a case of opportunistic archaeological looting. Lord Byron, Elgin's contemporary, certainly takes this view, referring to Elgin as a spoiler and plunderer in his poem The Curse of Minerva, which was written in Athens. We may never know for sure, but what we can say is that he did remove pieces of the Parthenon, and those pieces are still in England. Whether or not Lord Elgin had the right to bring the marbles back to England is difficult to say. There's a controversial Italian document between Elgin and the Ottoman authorities giving him permission to make excavations at the Parthenon, but some scholars question the validity of the document or the conditions under which the agreement was made. This begs the question, were the Parthenon marbles the Ottoman Empire's to give away? A few years after Elgin removed the marbles, the Greeks won the War of Greek Independence and expelled the Turks from the country. Now, if at the time of removal, Lord Elgin had a claim to preservation, and it seems clear that he had, that claim is no longer valid. Greece has built a museum, the Acropolis Museum, at the foot of the Acropolis with the bones of the Parthenon in view. It's been designed to house the complete original metopes, friezes, and sculptures together safely. The Greek hope is for the restoration and reunification of the Parthenon marbles in the place where they were first made, over 2,000 years ago. Thematically, this makes a lot of sense. These sculptures are technically part of the same structure of the Parthenon. They're part of a single narrative, and as such, are intended to be read together. Equally, the Parthenon marbles are a fundamentally Greek artifact, made by Greek people, about Greek identity and heritage. Greece is their home, and there's a sense that the marbles, to some extent, belong there. So, what does the UK say? According to the British government, this isn't a governmental affair. Rather, the British Museum's trustees, who are generally appointed by the government, must take the decision on whether to return the marbles or not. The official position of the museum is this, that the Parthenon marbles were acquired by Lord Elgin legally in accordance with the legal structure of that time. They are open to loan requests and would readily lend the marbles to the Acropolis Museum. There is a difference between experiencing the marbles in an exclusively Greek context, as in the Acropolis Museum, versus experiencing them in dialogue with the artistic achievements of other cultures which the British Museum provides. And the British people? According to a poll by YouGov, 37% of Britons want to return the marbles, and 23% want to keep them in the British Museum. The rest are undecided. So what do you think? Should the British Museum return the Parthenon marbles to Greece, or should they remain in the collection? Let us know in the comments below. And if you've enjoyed this video and would like to see more like it, give us a like or hit the subscribe button now, as it really does help us out a lot. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, please consider supporting us on Patreon at the link in the description box below. As a Quince patron, you'll get early access to future videos and can even vote on upcoming video topics. Our amazing patrons allow us to work on these videos full-time and make them as good as we possibly can. Thank you all very, very much for your support.